Hey everyone, Rupak Nepali again. In our last video, we talked about things to consider while creating database in OpenCart. Today we are talking about OpenCart library predefined objects method. As OpenCart has a lot of predefined objects, and objects has a functions associated with it that are known as objects method. Here we show predefined objects that OpenCart provide for which you don't need to create or initialize the objects. You can use it directly. So better to know them so that it helps on achieving. Don't repeat yourselves. Don't write code unless you should. Write code only what you need. If you miss these predefined objects method, then you may repeat codes. So you can find predefined objects method at system library. OpenCart has many predefined objects methods that can be called in controller and model. Like in admin section, we can see predefined objects like config, log, events, load, request, response, DB sessions, cache, URL, language, Openbay, documents, customer, currency, tax, weight, length, cart, encryptions, model settings, underscore event, users. So you can find all of these at system library. So all of these objects can be found in here. You can find in here. Let's take an example of database objects. Database objects of OpenCart is this dash db, which has following methods. Db escape, this acts as a MySQL real escape string on the value passed, count affected, rows affected by an update query, get last ID, last auto increment ID, same as MySQL insert ID, connected, ping a server connection or tries to reconnect if the connection has gone down, queries, all SQL queries are run from these db query methods, which looks like these db queries, select asterisk from this, replace, insert, delete, update, and this query method returns three properties, which are num rows. So num rows is like get the number of the rows in the result, and row get the first row data, and rows gets an array of row results. So let's see this in the code. So we take the db, let's take the MySQL I. So you can see the constructor here, constructor, and you see the queries query, which sets the results of num rows and return the result, and escape, count affected, get last ID, connected, and destructor. So these methods are called in the model of the OpenCart in admin or catalog. Next, it's PHP super global variables in OpenCart. So dollar underscore server acts as this server, this request server, dollar underscore get acts as this request get. So only dollar underscore session acts as this session data. So all of these predefined variables in PHP are super global variables, which means they are available in all scope throughout the script. There is no need to do global dollar variables to access them within function or method. So we can directly access in OpenCart like this. So let's see this reference in controller. Let's go to the admin controller extension model account.psv. Let's say extension modules Let's edit the account. So you can see all objects that you can use in this class. OpenBay, config log, event load, request response, DB, URL, language, document, customer, currency, tax, weight, length, card, encryption, users. So you can use all of these objects in this class. $this is a reference to the calling objects, usually the objects to which the method belongs. So you can see the protected modifier register which has these objects. Now let's take the config objects and see what are the methods that the config objects hold. So the config objects has these four methods: get, set, has, and load. Now you can see the list of methods that you can use in your config objects. Let's see the parameters that you can use in the get and set methods. So to check, let's do verdom this config. So you can see all of the data, all of the parameters that we can use in get and set. Let's get the site URL. This config get and site URL. You get the values of the that site URLs. Like this way you can keep on using other objects and methods that OpenCart provide. Let's take another example of the customer predefined objects method provided by the OpenCart. For that we can see at system library cart and customer.php. So let's go to the system library cart customer.php. You can see the namespace cart, which is like a directory. In OpenCart tree, customer is under cart namespace. Customer objects is initiated as new cart slash customer and registered with the registry. So in customer class, there are private properties and public methods. So private properties are like customer ID, first name, last name, telephone, news address, address ID. So public methods are login, logout, is logged, get ID, first name, get last name, get group ID, get email, get telephone, get newsletter, get address, get balance, get rewards. These public methods are available in controller and model class of modules, which I already showed for config objects. It is similar for other objects. You can see the login methods of customer objects. I already showed for config objects, and it's similar for other objects as well. So you can keep on using these methods provided by the OpenCart. Now let's go to the customers. So customer has a login, so you can find codes used at catalog controller. Let's see that one. Catalog controller account login.php. So I think you can see that like this customer login here, which passes the email and the password. So customer login scripts at system library, card, customer database is used to provide authentication for customer section of OpenCart, and customer section is activated for customer ID, first name, last name, customer group ID are assigned when they are logged in. So same with customer logout is logged in, checks whether the customer ID is active or not, get ID, returns the active customer ID, get first name returns the active customer first name, get last name returns the active customer last name, get email returns active customer email, phone, similarly get newsletter, get address ID, balance, get reward points. Some other predefined objects provided by OpenCart are following: card, currency, customer length, tags, which you can find on system/library folder. So you get where to see the OpenCart library predefined objects methods which we can use in our model and controller classes. So keep on ticking. So for detailed description of predefined methods of OpenCart, you can read OpenCart theme and model development books where they defined most of the objects. Like this way we completed our fifth video, OpenCart library predefined objects method. In our next video we will show OpenCart code flow, request and response in OpenCart. So keep on tuning. I have completed this figure, but still there are a lot of work to be done. As always, please don't forget to post your questions or comment so that I can add extra topics or things that I need to develop. You can follow at my Twitter account RupakNPL. Subscribe our YouTube channel Online Gyan Nepal. Similarly, keep on visiting my personal blog where you can find a lot of free modules. See you in next video. Happy learning and thanks for watching videos.